Good morning, viewers. Today I am present before you with the topic that is understanding feminism through the perspective of the feminist writer Toril Moy. Before I begin the podcast, it is advisable that you keep a notebook and a pen so that you can jot down the important points relating to this particular topic. It is further advisable to use earplugs for better listening. So here I begin. Toril Moy, the celebrated feminist, in her famous essay, Feminist Literary Criticism, rationally defines feminist literary criticism. She clearly distinguishes between the keywords feminist, female, and feminine, and defines them to signify important categories in feminist theory. According to her, the word feminist, which means a person who supports the belief that women should have the same rights and opportunities, suggests political connotations. Female, which means being woman or girl, or of women, typical of women and affecting women, connotes biological category, and the word feminine, which implies connected with women, denotes cultural aspect and category. The term feminist was very popular in 1960s when the feminist movement gathered momentum. It was a clarion call for liberation of women from gender-based discriminations and exploitations. The word feminist highlighted the struggle against patriarchy and sexism. It was not just a branch of literary criticism. Kate Millett, in her famous book Sexual Politics, vehemently asserts that the oldest and most pervasive form of exploitation is the power exercised by the males over females. Sex, thus, has played an outstanding role in the consolidation of patriarchal system of political and social power. In the cultural and social atmosphere in patriarchal society, the growth of the feminist perception is severely affected. However, the feminist space has to be carved out in what Toril Moy calls contamination by patriarchal ideology. Toril Moy distinguishes between transforming ideas and stealing ideas. She cites many examples from Del Spender's book Women of Ideas and What Men Have Done to Them, in which many writers have presented women's ideas as their own without any kind of acknowledgement of their borrowing. On the other hand, women critics and writers borrow men's ideas in order to interpret and transform the prevalent beliefs and assumptions for strengthening and nourishing feminist viewpoint. Ideas are public property, but to own others' ideas as one's own is downright dishonesty. Male ideology and theories must be divested of penumbra of objectivity and neutrality so that they are exposed with all their supports and political constructs. Women are free to appropriate and transform others' ideas for fulfilling their political purposes. For example, Freudian psychoanalysis has been transformed into a theory of female source of difference and the construction of gender in patriarchal society. Hence, contemporary literary criticism has such renowned theorists as Helen Csikszentmihalyi, Lucy Irigaray, and many others who have been highly influenced by Jacques Derrida, Sandra Gilbert, Susan Guber, Ellen Showalter, and many more. The term female connotes writings by women, which does not imply feminist writings. Everything written by women does not present or articulate an attitude against patriarchal, social and other constructs. Women writings in the past expose the male arrogance of the kind of patriarchal stereotyping feminists want to combat. Rosalind Coward, in her essay entitled Are Women Novels Feminist Novels?, observed that women novelists have only been strengthening the conventional and stereotyped portrayal of women designed and planned by men. Feminine is a cultural construct and differs from female and feminist. According to Toril Moy, it means patterns of sexuality and behavior imposed by cultural and social norms. This premise implies that one is not born a woman, one becomes one. Simone de Beauvoir, in her famous book The Second Sex, frankly and clearly deals with the study of the subtle evolution of the sexist system in the social organization. She writes, "Woman is riveted into a lopsided relationship with man. He is the one, she is the other. Man's dominance has secured an ideological climate of compliance. Legislators, priests, philosophers, writers, and scientists have striven to show that the subordinate position of women is willed in heaven and advantageous on earth. Man determines even what is natural for woman. Thus, the patriarchal manifestation of femininity is a curious amalgam of ideologies, concepts, behavioral patterns, literature, arts, and dress code. Feminists assert that it is natural for women to be female, but it does not mean that they will be feminine." According to Toril Moy, feminist criticism and theory are two different categories. Female criticism reduces women to the status of interesting scientific objects on a par with insects or nuclear particles. It is not mainly feminist, but it is simply concerned with the study of women. It adopts a somewhat political or disinterested line of study with regard to women. The second category deals with gynocritics, or women as writers and critics. These two theories homogenize all female writings into feminist self-expression. According to her, the feminine theory deals with the construction of femininity. A theory with female qualities at its center is likely to be opposed by biologism and patriarchal theories. Toril Moy suggests that it is necessary to at once deconstruct the opposition between traditionally masculine and feminine values and to confront the full political force and reality of such categories. After much serious deliberation, she defines female as writing by women, irrespective of its nature and tenor. Feminist implies anti-sexist and anti-patriarchal position, and feminine stands for the exploited, marginalized, and muted class by ruling social linguistic order. Definitions, labels, and categories do not put an end to the debate, but they begin it. According to her, there is nothing like intrinsically feminist text. It is the social and historical context that offers the angle for recuperating all text. The feminist critics should vehemently oppose the patriarchal critics and thinkers who steal from feminist critics. What is important is to eye the aim steadily and continue to create a feminist space. So this was something about how Toril Moy observes the whole idea of feminism. I hope this podcast proves to be of help in making you understand this idea of female, feminine, and feminist in a better way. In the comment section below, you can share your feedback or any of the related questions pertaining to this particular podcast. It is further expected that you share this link with as many people as you know, so that they can get a better understanding of this whole idea of feminism. Thank you for your valuable time. Here's wishing you a great day. And in the description box below, please visit the literature blog that I have already mentioned in my previous podcast. Here wishing you a great day.